Established Kids. I'm Catherine, and I'm really excited to be with you here today to read our story together. I hope you've enjoyed our kids Zoom call. It's always great to see all your happy, smiling faces, singing songs together, learning Bible memory verses. It's always such an encouraging time to be together. And we're looking forward to soon being able to actually meet together in person. But until then, we're going to keep reading our stories online. I hope you enjoyed last week's story by Quizworks, where we learned about building our lives on the rock, not building it on a shaky foundation or a weak foundation like the houses that got built on the sand, but to build our lives on the rock, and that rock is Jesus. So I hope you really enjoyed that story last week. Maybe you made a house out of Play-Doh or some other construction material so you could remember how important it is to build your life on the rock, just like the wise man who built his house on the rock. Well, this week, we're going to be starting a new series of books. And the first one today is this one here. It's called You Are Special. And I'm really excited to read it with you. And afterwards, we're going to have a little read of some verses from the Bible too. And we're going to have a think about how those verses from the Bible and this story match up and what that means for you guys. Because there's a really important message in here. You might have guessed what the message might be. There's a clue on the front page of this book. It says, you are special. So let's read the story together and see what this story teaches us. The Wemmicks were small wooden people. All of the wooden people were carved by a woodworker named Eli. His workshop sat on a hill overlooking their village. I think this must be the workshop up here. Each Wemmick was different. Some had big noses, others had large eyes, some were tall, and others were short. Some wore hats, others wore coats, but all were made by the same carver, and all lived in the village. I wonder if you think about your family and your friends, what differences can you see in all of those people? We all look very different, don't we, in many ways, but sometimes there's people that we look a bit like, or maybe there's people that we act like. But the special thing, just like all of the Wemmicks, they were made by the same carver. We were made by the same God. That's a pretty awesome truth. All day, every day, the Wemmicks did the same thing. They gave each other stickers. Each Wemmick had a box of golden star stickers and a box of grey dot stickers. There he is getting a grey dot sticker out of his box. This one's popping a golden star sticker on over here. Up and down the streets all over the city, people spent their day sticking stars or dots on one another. The pretty ones, those with smooth wood and fine paint, always got stars. But if the wood was rough or the paint chipped, the Wemmicks gave dots. I think they might prefer to get the stars than the dots. What do you think? The talented ones got stars too. Some could lift big sticks high above their heads or jump over a tall box. Look at this one doing a handstand on top of a big box. Still others knew big words or could sing pretty songs. Everyone gave them stars. Some Wemmicks had stars all over them. Every time they got a star, it made them feel so good. It made them want to do something else to get another star. Others, though, could do little. They got dots. Punchinello was one of these. He tried to jump high like the others, but he always fell. And when he fell, the others would gather round and give him dots. Sometimes when he fell, his wood got scratched, so the people would give him more dots. Then when he tried to explain why he had fallen, he would say something silly, and the Wemmicks would give him more dots. After a while, he had so many dots that he didn't want to go outside. He was afraid he would do something silly, such as forget his hat or step in the water, and then people would give him another dot. In fact, he had so many grey dots that some people came up and gave him dots for no reason at all. Poor Punchinello. That doesn't sound very fun, does it? He deserves lots of dots. The wooden people would agree with one another. He's not a good wooden person. After a while, Punchinello believed them. I'm not a good Wemmick, he would say. A few times he went outside, he hung around other Wemmicks, who also had lots of dots. He felt better around them. One day, he met a Wemmick who was unlike any he had ever met. She had no dots or stars. She was just wooden. Her name was Lucia. It wasn't that people didn't try to give her stickers. It was just that the stickers didn't stick. Some of the Wemmicks admired Lucia for having no dots, so they would run up and give her a star, but it would fall off. Others looked down on her for having no stars, so they would give her a dot, but that wouldn't stick either. I wonder what's different about Lucia. That's the way I want to be, thought Punchinello. I don't want anyone's marks. So he asked the stickerless Wemmick how she did it. It's easy, Lucia replied. Every day I go to see Eli. Do you remember who Eli is? We heard about him right at the beginning of the story. Eli? Yes, Eli, the woodcarver. I sit in the workshop with him. Why? Well, why don't you find out for yourself? Go up the hill. He's there. And with that, the Wemmick, who had no stickers, turned and skipped away. But will he want to see me? Punchinello cried out. Lucia didn't hear, so Punchinello went home. He sat near a window and watched the wooden people as they scurried around, giving each other stars and dots. It's not right, he muttered to himself, and he decided to go and see Eli. He walked up the narrow path to the top of the hill and stepped into the big shop. His wooden eyes widened at the size of everything. The stool was as tall as he was. He had to stretch on his tiptoes to see the top of the workbench. A hammer was as long as his arm. Punchinello swallowed hard. I'm not staying here. And he turned to leave. Then he heard his name. Punchinello. The voice was deep and strong. Punchinello stopped. Punchinello, how good to see you. Come and let me have a look at you. Punchinello turned slowly and looked at the large bearded craftsman. You know my name? The little Wemmick asked. Of course I do. I made you. Eli stooped down and picked him up and set him on the bench. The maker spoke thoughtfully as he looked at the grey dots. Looks like you've been given some bad marks. I didn't mean to, Eli. I really tried hard. Oh, you don't have to defend yourself to me, child. I don't care what the other Wemmicks think. You don't? No, and you shouldn't either. Who are they to give you stars or dots? They're Wemmicks, just like you. What they think doesn't matter, Punchinello. All that matters is what I think. And I think you are very special. Punchinello laughed. Me? Special? Why? I can't walk fast. I can't jump. My paint is peeling. Why do I matter to you? Eli looked at Punchinello, put his hands on those small wooden shoulders and spoke very slowly. Because you're mine. That's why you matter to me. Punchinello had never had anyone look at him like this, much less his maker. He didn't know what to say. Every day I've been hoping you'd come, Eli explained. I came because I met someone who had no marks, said Punchinello. I know. She told me about you. Why don't the stickers stay on her? The maker spoke softly. Because she has decided that what I think is more important than what they think. The stickers only stick if you let them. What? The stickers only stick if they matter to you. The more you trust my love, the less you care about their stickers. I'm not sure I understand. Eli smiled. You will, but it will take time. You've got a lot of marks. For now, just come and see me every day and let me remind you how much I care. Eli lifted Punchinello off the bench and set him on the ground. Remember, Eli said as the Wemmick walked out of the door, you are special because I made you and I don't make mistakes. Punchinello didn't stop, but in his heart he thought, I think he really means it. And when he did, a dot fell to the ground. Now, in that story, there was a few characters. Those characters aren't in the Bible with those names. But Eli is meant to represent God, because he made all of us. And Punchinello is just a person like us. And I'm going to now read to you from the Bible, from one of the Psalms. It's Psalm 139. And this psalm tells us what God thinks about us and how he made us and how we're so special to him. So if you can, listen carefully. And then I'm going to help you to understand a little bit more about this story. Psalm 139. You have searched me, Lord, and you know me. You know when I sit and when I rise. You perceive my thoughts from afar. You discern my going out and my lying down. You are familiar with all of my ways. Wow, what an amazing God to know all of that about us. Where can I go from your spirit? Where can I flee from your presence? If I go up to the heavens, you are there. If I make my bed in the depths, you are there. How amazing that God is everywhere. Wherever we are, he is. We can't run away from him because he's always with us. You created my inmost being. You knit me together in my mother's womb. I praise you because I am fearfully and wonderfully made. Your works are wonderful. The person who wrote this psalm, this poem, is remembering how much God loves us and how he made us. He made each one of us. He knit us together inside our mother's womb. Just like Eli carved the Wemmicks out of wood, God made us. Real people. Isn't that amazing? And the psalmist knows that his works are wonderful. God doesn't make mistakes. He made every single one of you, and each of you is really special to God. Sometimes we care more about what other people think about us, and we worry about what other people might think. Maybe we feel shy or think that they might not like us. But do you know what? God loves you, and God cares for you. And the important thing to remember from this story is that what God thinks about you is the only thing that matters. Can you remember what happened at the end? Eli said something important to Punchinello. He said, it might take you a while to work this out because for a long time you've cared about what other people think and they've put so many dots on you, you don't think very much. But what he said is, if you come and spend time with me, then you'll start to see how special I think you am. And so for us, what we can remember and what this story helps us to remember is that the more we spend time with God, the more we read the Bible together, the more we talk to him, the more we spend time with other Christians who are going to teach us about God, maybe coming to the Zoom meetings and listening to these stories, There's many ways that we can spend time with God. We can listen to music and sing songs like we've been doing together today. All of those things help us to remember how special God thinks we are, and that's the most important thing. I hope you've enjoyed listening today. You've got some activity sheets to do while Mum and Dad do church together. So please enjoy those activity sheets. Keep listening, keep learning, and keep growing in your relationship with God. I'm going to pray now. Lord, I thank you so much for Established Kids. I thank you for all these wonderful children that you've given to us. And Lord, we thank you that they love you and know you, but most importantly, that you love them and you know them. You knew them before they even were created inside their mummies. You knew everything about them and you made them so special. And we thank you so much for that truth. And we ask that you help us to keep remembering that every single day. Amen. Bye, Established Kids.